7223 South on Ashland Avenue in Chicago, Illinois, where Elder Connie Boatman is our pastor and overseer. If you desire prayer on tonight, you can call us at 708-982-1789. Once again, that number is 708-982-1789. We also invite you to come out and join us in our weekly services. Every Sunday morning at 9:30 a.m. is our church school. 11:30 a.m. is our morning worship service, and we are in prayer each Monday night from 7 to 8. This is a church that believes in the power of prayer. And our weekly fellowship service is every Friday night. Prayer is at 7:30 p.m., and then we go directly into praise and worship and hearing of the Word of God. If you'd like to email us or comment on the service, we ask that you email us at dpcenter@ameritech.net. That's dpcenter@ameritech.net. Once again, you're welcome to all and any of our services. We thank and praise God for your tuning in on tonight. Truly, you will be blessed by the Word of God, because that's what we offer out to you tonight, the Word of God. He sent His Word to heal us and to deliver us from our destruction. So stay tuned in. God has something good for you on tonight. It's this time we will have prayer by Brother Fletcher Neely. Amen.
Amen. Glory. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we asking you, Lord, to come into this house on today, oh Lord. Travel through the airways on today, oh Lord. Travel along on today, oh Lord. Touch and heal and set free on today, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. Touch that soul, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Save that individual on today, Lord. In the name of Jesus. We love you on today, oh Lord. We come to lift you up. We come to give you glory. Hallelujah. Thank you for your son, Jesus, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Save and deliver on today. In your son, Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen, amen. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Once again, we'd like to welcome you to our telecast on tonight. Again, this is the Deliverance Prayer Center. We're located at 7223 South Ashland Avenue in Chicago, Illinois, where Elder Connie Boatman is our pastor and overseer. If you desire prayer, our phone number is 708-982-1789. Again, that's 708-982-1789. Now we like to present you your speaker for the evening, a powerful woman of God, a student in the Word of God, powerful in stature and powerful in the Word of God. Your announcer for this telecast has been Sister Barbara Anderson. Please stay tuned in. You have the best is yet to come. Your speaker for tonight is Evangelist Viola Ball.
Glory to God. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, Oh, glory to God, glory to God. Amen. The Bible says it's a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praise unto the Almighty. Again, we honor God on tonight and to his most precious son, Jesus Christ. Amen. We honor our leader. Amen. Elder Connie Boatman. Praise the Lord and his lovely wife. Amen. Evangelist Lorraine Boatman. We want to get the announcement out again, praise God, before we get into the message on tonight. As the announcer has forestated, if you desire to call in, that number again is 708-982-1789. And if you care to give us a visit, the location is 7223 South on Ashland Avenue here in Chicago, Illinois. Amen. Amen. You will not be disappointed, amen, in coming by giving us a visit. We want to go, amen, into the word of God. Praise the Lord. We're living in times, glory to God, amen, that we need the Lord. Amen. 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 The Bible teaches us, if you have your Bibles, those that are viewing this telecast and those that are sitting in the sanctuary, amen, the book of Ephesians, the 6th chapter, praise God, amen, and we will begin reading at verse 14. Amen. The Bible said, wherefore he saith, awake thou that sleepeth, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light. Well, see then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise. And here's the verse that we want to zero in on. Verse 16, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. Amen. And the subject is from that particular scripture, redeeming the time. Amen. In other words, making use of your time. Praise God. Amen. Managing your time. Not long ago, a few years, amen, I retired from the United States Postal Service. And like most retiree, it's your leisure time. You do what you want to do. You do it when you want to do it. You do it how long you want to do it. Amen. You have no certain plan, no certain schedule. Praise God. You use your time and manage your time according to how you want it. But God is telling us in the spiritual realm, amen, making use of your time, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. We're living in a nation where judgment, glory be to God, has turned away backwards. Justice standeth out in the street. Amen. Truth lieth in the street. Amen. Justice is turned away backwards. Glory to God. And equity cannot enter. Amen. The laws are being made, praise God, contrary to the word of God. Amen. The enemy is on his job. John 10 and 10 say, amen, the thief cometh but to kill, steal, and to destroy. He come to distract us. Amen. He come to get us off track. He come to get us off focus. And what as we as God's people doing? Amen. We should be doing, praise God, as Psalms 90 and 12 says, amen. Oh, Lord, teach us that we may number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. So what is that scripture saying? It is saying, teach us how to allocate our time. Amen. Teach us how to distribute our time. Teach us how to use our time wisely. Amen. Because time is of the essence. Amen. We're living in critical times. Amen. The Bible teaches us and it says we are living in perilous time. Amen. In the last days. Amen. Perilous time shall come. Glory be to God. Men will be lovers of themselves. There will be covetousness. Praise God. Truth breakers. Glory to God. All kinds of evilness and weakness. And what are the saints doing? We must redeem the time. We must, while we have the opportunity, to take advantage. Amen. To make the most of the time that we have. We should be just as Jesus himself was. Praise God. Jesus told his parents, glory to God, amen, that I must be about my Father's business. Amen. He told them that, amen, we have to go back to the beginning, amen, of St. Luke, the 2nd chapter, and it teaches how that, amen, each year they will go up to Jerusalem for a feast. Glory to God. Amen. And after the feast was completed, they would leave. And on this particular time, they left, and the Bible said Jesus tarried behind. Amen. So his parents went a day's journey, assuming that he was with the relatives, assuming that he was with friends. You know how we be. Oh, so-and-so, little Johnny is over there with cousin whomever. Praise God. So we're not concerned about it. But the Bible said they went on and then they discovered that he wasn't there.
My Lord.
3 days, they discovered that he wasn't there. They returned back to Jerusalem. Amen. And they found him in the temple.
Yes.
And when they went in the temple, they were astonished. Amen. To hear him speak. And not only the doctors that was talking to Jesus, but they were astonished to the response that Jesus was giving the doctors.
Yes.
Amen. And the mother began to say in St. Luke 2:48, and when they saw him, they were amazed. And his mother said unto him, Son, why hast thou thus dealt with us? Behold, thy father and I have sought thee sorrow. Amen. They were looking for their child because they had no idea where he was.
Amen.
But here's the response that Jesus gave in verse 49. And he said unto them, how is it that ye sought me? In other words, what means were you seeking me?
Come on.
You know, it's 3 days and you didn't miss me.
Right.
Praise God. Amen. He said, wist ye not that I must be about my father's business.
Yes.
Jesus was about doing the will, amen, of God.
Yes.
Amen. And we have to be the same way. Praise God. God saved us for a purpose,
yes,
and he saved us with a purpose.
Amen.
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 Glory to God. So we don't have time, amen, to mess around. We don't have time, amen, to waste time. Because wasted time, you can't get it back. Amen. Praise God. When wasted time, you can't even make it up. Is that right?
Right.
Glory be to God. Amen. But I want to go, amen, into the Old Testament, to the book of Nehemiah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. The 6th chapter. Praise God. One verse out of that 6th chapter. And I sent messengers, praise God, unto them saying, I am doing a great work.
Yes.
Look at this. So that I cannot come down. Why should the work cease whilst I leave it and come down? Now we have to go back, amen, and to the history of why Nehemiah said this.
Uh-huh.
Nehemiah was the king cupbearer.
Yes.
Amen. In other words, he was the one that tested the wine before the king would drink it. And he was in the palace, the Bible said, and his brothers came from Jerusalem, and he began to inquire to them, how is the Jews that were left back there in captivity? And how is the land of Jerusalem doing? And the report that they gave Nehemiah was not a good one. Amen. Praise God. Amen. He said, the people that are in captivity, they're in great affliction.
My God.
He said, the walls is turned down and the gates are broken down. And that broke Nehemiah's heart.
Yes. Yes.
He began to go to God in prayer. Glory to God. And in his prayer, he began to say, Lord, grant it unto the king that he give me permission to go back to Jerusalem,
to
rebuild the wall around Jerusalem and put the gate back up. See, he was about his father's business.
Yes.
Glory be to God. He was concerned about, amen, Jerusalem. Amen. Concerned about the place where his father's sepulchres were.
Yes.
Glory to God. And the Bible says as time went on, and he came before the king, and the king saw something about Nehemiah that he had not seen before. Nehemiah's countenance, his face was saddened. And the king began to say, what is wrong with you, seeing that you're not sick? Why are you sad? And Nehemiah began to say, why shouldn't I be sad when the land where my father's sepulchre are, amen, lieth in wait? Glory to God. So, I mean, Nehemiah made the stories, I mean, from his heart until the king asked him, how long do you want to be gone? Do you want to go? Praise God. Amen. And Nehemiah, amen, adhered to him. He said he began to pray. When you need, amen, to be about God's business, you need direction. And he began to pray unto God. The king granted, to make the story short, the king granted him permission to return back to Jerusalem to build the wall. And here it ends in the 6th chapter, when he went back to do the work of God, when he was redeeming the time, when he was making good use of your time. So you got to beware of the devil. He's cunning and he's slick. He's very, very crafty.
Come on.
When you're doing a work for God,
yes,
he will do everything he can to distract you.
Yes.
We have to be about our Father's business.
Amen.
Amen. Sometime, amen, some of us or some of you that are saved, throughout the day you pray. Or you set aside a time where you pray unto God. It's at that time the phone gonna ring.
Oh,
it's at that time somebody knocking at the door.
Yes.
Glory be to God. Amen. But I tell you, praise God, amen, technology that we have today, it's very good. Yes. So it gives us, if you got a cell phone, amen, you have a screen on there to say, scroll, delete. When you see it, praise, when you see that number, scroll down and delete it. Amen. Just delete it all out altogether to let nothing distract you. Amen. Praise God. Nehemiah refused to come down off of the wall.
My Lord.
Amen. The enemy came five times to get him to come off the wall. And each time he told him no. Amen. When the enemy come to distract you and take you away from what God, amen, has given you to do, we have to be about witnessing. See, when God, amen, sent the Holy Ghost on the day of Pentecost, praise God, and he said, ye shall receive power, he also added something else to that. He said, and ye shall be witnesses unto me. Amen. In Jerusalem, in Samaria, in Judea, and into the uttermost parts of the earth. Amen. God is telling us the same thing as he told his disciples, amen, in the book of St. Mark. He told him to go ye into all the world. Amen. And preach the gospel to every creature. Are you about your Father's business?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Bible said, awake thou that sleepeth and arise from the dead. Yeah. Now, he was not talking about the dead under the ground. He's talking about the dead that's dead in him. Spiritually dead.
Yeah.
We have to wake up. Shake ourselves, glory to God, and be about the business of our Father. Amen. Stop allowing the enemy to distract you. Stop allowing the enemy to hinder you. Glory be to God. We have to be about our Father's business. Nehemiah met with some professional distractors. They knew what they were doing. Sanballat, Tobias, praise God, when they came, come on down. Let us go meet in a certain place. Let us sit down and talk. Oh, the enemy can have it smooth and nice.
Yes.
He know how to lure you. Praise God. And when he gets you over on the other side, praise God, amen, you'll see a different picture.
Yes,
but Nehemiah, his main mission was to rebuild the wall.
Amen.
His mission was to put the gate back up around the city that God had given him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want you to know that we have to protect our salvation because the enemy is right there to snatch it from us. Amen. When sickness hit us, the first thing the enemy said, you're going to die. Glory be to God. But you got to rebuke the enemy.
Amen.
You don't hear that term too much today in the churches. Rebuke the enemy.
Amen.
But you got to rebuke that enemy and tell him you are alive. You shall not die, but you shall live and to declare the glory of God. Amen. To do the works of the Lord. Amen. Nehemiah stayed on the walls. Amen. He had a designation that he had to be at. Praise God. We've got a destination to be. Amen. Time is winding up. Glory be to God. Amen. Time is short. The Bible says the enemy knows that he has but a short time. But what are we doing in the time that we have? Are we witnessing? Are we telling somebody about the Lord? Are we telling somebody there is a better way? Are we telling somebody that I know a man who can save you, who can deliver you, who can change your life? I know somebody who can give you a new heart. Glory to God. Are we about our Father's business? Are we redeeming the time? Glory be to God. Amen. One other scripture in the book of St. Luke, the 19th chapter. Amen. Quickly, this was a parable that Jesus gave. Amen. And this was concerning being faithfulness. The Bible said there was a certain nobleman, and he had went over into another country. But before he left, he called his servants. Glory be to God. And he gave each of them, amen, a talent. Praise God. And the talent here refers to money. And he wanted them to invest that money. Amen. As a matter of fact, it said, and he called 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds and said unto them, occupy till I come.
Yes, go ahead.
Occupy till I come. Normally, when we look at the word occupy, it means to fill a position. But in this scripture, it means to make use of what I've given you. Amen. Put it out and gain more.
Yes.
Glory be to God.
Go ahead.
Amen. So he left and went into the foreign country. When he came back, one of the servants came, the 10 pounds that you gave me, I added 10 more. He said, well done. That good and faithful servant. Amen. The next one came, the 2 that you gave me, the 5 I added on. But there was one who only received 1 pound.
My Lord.
And he said, I buried it. Amen. That was not being about the master's business. Amen, amen. What God has given us, saints, yes. What God has given you to yes. do, it is time that you get up. Yes. Awake thou that sleepeth. Arise, and Christ shall give thee light. Amen. Redeem the time, because the days are evil. It's going to get worse before it gets better. But God is encouraging us tonight. Glory to God. If we be about our Father's business, He will make a way out of no way. Somebody need to know that they can make it. Glory to God. Somebody need to know they don't have to stay in that situation. They don't have to be stuck in it. Glory to God. But just stand on the word of God and allow God to use you. Allow God, amen, to speak through you.
Yes,
we're all targets for the devil.
Right.
Amen. He's throwing his darts.
Yes,
but what are we doing? Are we dodging it? No, we should supposed to have the enemy under our feet. Let us make use of the time that God has given us.
Yes,
it is God's will, amen, that we do his business.
Amen.
Glory be to God. Amen. Just as he was with his son, he will be with us.
Amen.
Be encouraged to know what you do for the Lord, it will last.
Amen.
This is why Paul said, be ye steadfast,
yes.
unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. We thank you once again for tuning into this telecast. Amen. Praise God. We just want to pray the prayer of faith. Heavenly righteous Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word that you sent forth, O God. You said in your word, you sent your word to heal them and to deliver them from their destruction. We ask you to have your way in Jesus' name. Touch that heart, O God. Awake them out of their sleepness, O God. In the name of Jesus, give us to do your will, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. I got